All right, folks, if you can come back to our seats, I would really appreciate it. If I can please have Mr. Alberto Moreno, Maria Elisa, and Carlos, Dr. Carlos Crespo, if you could join us on the stage as well. Folks in the back, if we could start heading back to the table so we can get started. All right, folks, we're going to go ahead and get started. And as I get going, if you could make your way back to your table, I would appreciate that. So, as we mentioned this morning, OLAA wants to challenge our community to achieve equal representation by 2024. And I think the reading between that, or if you read it between the lines, the main question is, how are we going to accomplish that? And we heard from our panel this morning some great ideas, great insight on experiences, folks that have been through that process and are currently undergoing that process of taking a chance on a new opportunity to better our community and stepping into a leadership role that is completely foreign and new to them. And I just want to give another round of applause to those folks for being with us. And thank you. And just keep that energy going through the day so that we can continue to be present as our speakers are here to share some more of their insight. This vision of getting equal representation by 2024 is specifically focused on getting folks on state boards and commissions, getting folks in elected office, and also a big piece that maybe we haven't talked about much this morning is focusing on nonprofit boards and making sure that we have equal representation there as well. So here to give us more information on ways that we can get involved around the state, first I would like to introduce Maria Elisa Johnson, who's a consulting director at the Nonprofit Association of Oregon. And I would also, after Maria Elisa shares some information with us, we also have Mr. Alberto Moreno, who's the executive director
resource to you. Check them out. They're a resource to you. Not all of our organizations are. So at your tables, there's a quiz on nonprofits. And I think there's enough for everyone, but if there is, you can do it in pairs. And just take a couple minutes to complete that quiz and see how we fare. More on that table. So just a couple minutes. As much as possible, actually. position for this nonprofit, or am I seeing this as an opportunity to build my resume? Because honestly, if that's the only thing that's drawing you to nonprofit service, that is not the kind of leadership our community wants to promote. It will reflect poorly back on us. So, thank you. And I think there'll be a chance for questions after everyone presents. Thank you.
Buenos días. ¿Cómo están? ¿Dormidos? Okay, gran gusto. It's good to be here with you. Can you hear me in the back? Wonderful. Gracias. ¿Cómo me llamo? Alberto Moreno. Para servirles, Alberto Moreno Martínez, porque, bueno, en este país no siempre celebramos a nuestras madres, ¿verdad? Pero es importante reconocer de que nuestras culturas venimos de dos parentescos. Así es de que para servirles, someone mentioned that I'm the executive director for the Oregon Latino Health Coalition. And in that role, we help to make sure that all of our mothers and all of our children have the access to care that they need. We're very proud because in the last legislative session, we made prenatal care a human right in Oregon. So that it doesn't matter if our mothers are documented or undocumented, it's the right thing to do, and that is now possible. We also will be working this legislative session to make sure that over 20,000 undocumented children in the state, let me just repeat, 20,000 undocumented children in the state are currently left out of the state's Medicaid system and out of the Affordable Care Act, are able to receive the care that they need. They are currently and intentionally categorically excluded from receiving such care. But I'm here today as the chair for the Commission on Hispanic Affairs, and before I get started on my comments, I just want to ask all of you who sit on a commission to please stand up, or please. We want to recognize you, and we want to recognize your great service to this state. But I want to say that regardless of where you fall on the American political spectrum, the facts to keep in mind are these. There are only 28 Latino members of the House of Representatives. 9 of those are Latinas. There are only 3 Latino senators. All of them are Cuban American men. In the 2012 elections, 11 million Latinos voted. Over 12 million eligible Latinos did not. Let me say it again. Over 12 million eligible Latinos did not vote. This fact is actually more remarkable. 66,000 Latino citizens become eligible to vote every month, each and every month. In Oregon specifically, the number of Latinos serving on statewide boards and commissions is 119, which is slightly under 5% of the total number of commissions. This, by the way, is due to the great work of Ms. Kendall Clausen, who's not here with us today, and to Frank Garcia in his office. I just want to recognize him. When we largest number of any group of color that we have had since we started in 2011. And so we're making progress. I want to say that we are making progress, but we have not yet arrived, because as you know, we're about 12% of the population statewide. But we have made significant gains, and they are worth noting, and worth recording. Ultimately, Latino political priorities such as immigration reform and locally here drivers' cars will forever live or die in Washington or on the Capitol on the threat of enough registered voters taking action on election day. Our political heritage in America will be defined less by how we vote than by how many of us are registered to vote and where. This Hispanic Heritage Month, consider the impact you have by not just registering to vote, by registering your friends and neighbors, but also through your participation on Oregon's boards and commissions. And this month, it is true, we celebrate our Hispanic heritage. But it is, I would suggest to you, perhaps more important to ask, not what is our heritage, but what will be our legacy? Will it continue to be a legacy of silence? Will our greatest sin continue to be the sin of omission and non-participation? Now, I want you to know that I do not mean to malign silence, because silence, as Andrea Cano will have reminded you this morning, has its place. It's part of our spiritual tradition. I once took a sacred vow of silence for a month. So for me to talk about silence and sin is not an insignificant departure. But so profound is the absence of our voices that I have no choice but to conclude this, and that is that silence in the face of injustice is a sin. And so on this October morning, which celebrates us, I want to leave you with a question. Will our legacy continue to be a legacy of non-participation, or will we forge a new legacy, a new narrative of full civic participation that includes and defines us? And defines us not on anybody else's terms, not through anyone else's narrative, but through our own constructed narrative that affirms who we are as a people, as a community, as immigrants, as brothers and sisters, as mothers and fathers, so I want to invite you as the chair of the Commission on Hispanic Affairs to consider joining this August robust body, but also consider serving on the hundreds of other commissions. And you have, if you would do me the kindness of opening your packets, you have a list of those commissions and boards. And I want to show you, because the packet is about half an inch thick. And so this is the volume, I would say, of opportunity that each of you has to apply and serve on one of these boards. Because if your voice is not represented, if our voice is not represented, the decisions that are made in each one of these important bodies will not reflect the priorities of our respective communities. So I urge you to look at this vacancy list and consider applying for one of these boards and commissions. I also would be remiss if I, and we had not done this, but we have done this. We want to make this easy for you. There is an executive appointment interest form and instructions in your packet. Each one of you is here today because you are a respected, distinguished leader in your own right. No one can take that away from you. All that we ask is that you magnify that leadership, that you bring your vision to bear on this great state of Oregon. So I encourage you to apply. Thank you for your time this morning. It's now my great pleasure to introduce you to, where'd you go, Carlos? You're hiding behind me. Hi, everybody. It is my pleasure to introduce you to Carlos.
and we have been successful. That's the interesting part. We have been successful. Our first summit, we wanted to be able to provide the ability for anybody who can drive to drive and disconnect that from any immigration issue. And that happened. And that happened, and now we see. It's not over yet, though. It's not over. But we made that commitment and we were successful. We want to be able that anybody, any Latino, who grew up in Oregon, who wanted to go to a university or community college, didn't have to pay more or didn't have to go back all of a sudden because they wanted to advance their education. And we passed legislation with help of many people, Frank Garcia in the office of the governor and others, made tuition equity a legislation and it passed. And now, anybody who grew up in Oregon can go to college. You don't have to worry about paying more. So these are successes that we, as a group, decided this is what we want to do. We want to increase the representation of Latinos in the state legislature. And we have, technically, three legislatures. Diverse group, different minds, but we have at least some funny names that have to be pronounced when they talk about legislators in Salem. So today we're going to have a town hall meeting later, so it will be interesting to see what is it that we as a group are going to tell our legislators that we want to happen in the next couple of years. So think about these ideas. And I want to earlier read. Question about what is it that you do when you're elected, you're in this board. I happen to serve in the Oregon Latino Agenda for Action Nonprofit and also the Oregon Public Health Institute. Been appointed to the Oregon Health Policy Board, State Commission, and Task Force for the Future of Public Health. I serve with Alejandro in that task force. And the question about tokenism comes up, and I really don't care. They open the door, I stick my nose, and I push it until I open it. And I don't think anybody is asking you to be or do anything different than who you are. And you come in, you express your mind, and all the baggage that you bring, you have to bring it. And your lifetime experience, your values are reflected in your conversation. What I noticed also is that I learned as I start connecting with other people. And it is the mathematically right thing to do, that there will be one of us. It is the moral right thing to do, that there's representation from multiple parts of the society. It is also probably financially correct that people who spend money also represent the decisions that are made. But from a practical perspective, it is beneficial for everybody that there are diversity of opinions in all these deliberations. And today, it's going to be your opinion is your point of view. And there are other people who have different points of view. And the benefit of that is, if we don't have diversity of people, diversities of thought in these committees, we are going to try to keep solving the same problems with the same mental attitudes that we've been doing it. And those problems have not gone away. So having diverse people, having diverse point of view, even in this room today, help us finding solutions to problems that we haven't been able to solve. So that's one of the beauties of being brown, being from multiple places around the world, and bringing that experience to boards, to states, commissions, etc. So we had the opportunity to look at some data, a lot of work that I do has to do with data analysis, etc., and I'm not excusing that. But we went ahead and we did a quick analysis of the census data in terms of the Latino representation by counties. And you can see in the map that we're everywhere. And there why is that important? The majority of the decisions that are made that have an impact on us are made at the local level. You know that nothing happens in Washington, D.C. You know our Congress is completely inactive and paralyzed. It's the local decisions that happen at the school board, it's the local decisions that happen at the city level, it's the swimming pool that is closed in OLAA High School, the city, that have an impact on those kids who have a place to go and exercise. These are the decisions where we need to be present. You might want to be senator, you might want to be governor, we might have a Latina governor in 2024, but we have to start at some level. And I think it's important that we start thinking about how do I get engaged, how do I learn, how do I provide my point of view at some point where actually this will build upon the future. So we will put some of this information on our website, and if you have, this might be correct, there might be a dot that we missed, and you said, you know, my crossing is doing something somewhere. Let us know. We would love to fill this with a whole bunch of green dots, but that's what we have today. If you have some information, you can email it to us at olaaction@gmail.com. And today, after the keynote address, we'll be hearing from other Latinos who are currently holding any elected office. You will learn more about what it means to be in those positions. OLAA is looking for resources to bring more Latinos and train Latinos to run for office and to be able to help them how to run political campaigns. We're going to seek partnership with community organizations to do this work. And if you're interested in knowing more, please, we have an informational table. We'd love to have your name. We'd love to find you a mentor. We'd love to groom how is it that our future politicians exist. It's not by chance. A lot of this takes a long time. And then during lunch day, we will invite you to connect with our panelists. Some are here, some you have seen, and some they have their names. You can approach them. They're here on their own time because they're passionate about these issues, and they see the need for equal representation in our states. Please take full advantage of this knowledge and their presence in the summit. We've been doing this polling with the assistance of AARP, and I'm a member of AARP, a proud member of AARP. I have a card, and in addition to getting half-price popcorn at the theater, they do a lot of other good stuff that have nothing to do with popcorn. It's the only time I have to pull my AARP. Bandana, is she here?
Bandana?
For the last summits, we've been using this clicker technology, and you have it in your tables. And it's been a great way for us to keep track of who is present, but also where we're going to go next. And she's done a great job for the last two or three summits. So I'll ask her. She's Vandana Shrestha, is Director of Engagement, Peer Engagement at AARP, and she will review the process with us. So I am really excited, we'll have lunch later, et cetera, of the opportunity to work with you. Oh, she has a microphone there. All right, thank you very much.
Hola, buenos días y disculpen por favor la interrupción. Nomás un recordatorio de que tenemos audífonos aquí atrás en esta mesa para los que prefieren escuchar la presentación en español, así que por favor, si tienen interés, vengan a vernos. Gracias.
Thank you. I have no idea what you said because I don't speak Spanish. Even though I'm brown, I'm not Latino, but I feel like I'm one because I've been part of this for a long time. We sat together on the Oregon Health Coalition for a little while. summit, and you know, it's a small part of the agenda, but I think an interesting one. I remember the first time in Salem, how exciting it was, because it was actually even for us, we've had this technology for a long time at ARP, but the way we used it in the summit in Salem was actually a very, very unique way we have ever done, and it was live, because all the ideas were coming and we were typing and putting the poll questions together, and everybody got to vote, and you know, and then I remember how the key priority emerged about the driving issue. So today it's not going to be that exciting, but we have it's just a set of questions, and I think if you've been here before, you're pretty familiar with it. And I'm going to be needing Brian's help at the back, because I realized I didn't bring an advancer. So if you would please go and pick a polling unit in front of you, that would be great. Everybody got one? Yeah? Brian, can we go to the next slide? Yes, next one, please. Keep pressing. So basically, it works like a TV remote. But don't take it home, leave it in the little box thing, in the bowl. And you just push the button that's appropriate for the question that appears. And it's fully anonymous. I won't know who pressed what, so you're safe. And it will not be displayed individually. So let's go and go to the next question. Oh, the first question. So, did you attend the 2010 and or the 2012 OLAA Summit? Yes, if it's yes, just press one. If it's no, press two. Guys are such pros. You can see the responses at the bottom. I think it's slowed down, but everybody press. See, I just pressed mine. So okay, we're gonna go to the. Can you press the button? Advance button. There we go. Wow, look at that. We have 56% of you are brand new. So that's good news. That means we're reaching new people. So let's go to the next question. That is not open yet, so don't press anything. The polling has been closed. I don't know why the polling is closed. I'm going to go back here, and you're just going to have to tolerate me. You don't mind, do you? Okay. I don't know why the polling is closed, Brian, but if you don't mind, just don't look for a minute. Okay, good. Do this question again. Can you please press your answer? What are you looking forward to the most today at the summit? Okay, I think it's slowed down. I can't see very far. Has it slowed down? I'm gonna say let's go to the can you press advance it? All right. So it looks like most of you are looking forward to learning. Let's go to the next slide. What's your age range? Remember, it's a secret. All right. We'll go ahead and close the poll. All right, so looks like we are mostly 26 to 39. That's not me, but great. All right, let's go to the next one. Are you? Okay, we'll go ahead and close the poll. All right. Okay, so women and 30. So where do you live? There are 9 options. Just go ahead and press the appropriate button. I'm not reading it. If you need me to read it, you know. All right, we'll go ahead and close. I think we could do a couple more. So, all right, most of you are from Portland area, but we have lots of folks from all the list over here? Anybody want to tell me what the others are?
Vancouver?
Okay. Yes, we didn't put other parts of the state, so. Anybody else? All right. Let's go to the next one, Brian. In what area would you like to be more involved? State boards or commissions, elected positions, supporting a candidate, nonprofit board or other? Does anyone want to share? Education? Okay. Anybody else? Okay, let's go to the next one. I think we're nearing the end. If you are interested in elected office, what specific support do you need? So for those 16% that pressed that particular option, go ahead and tell us. Steps to get ready, politics and running for office, how to run a campaign, fundraising. Okay. Hey, more people, if they need, if they got support, might run for office, it looks like, right? So, because we have 39 responses. So instead of like 10 people who had pressed that option. So that's good. Let's press the button and see what folks said. Fundraising and steps to get ready for office. It's very interesting. Great. Great. Very helpful. Let's go to the next one. Do you think it's important to have a legislative agenda that addresses Latino-specific concerns? I have a grammatical mistake there. Yes, oh no. All right, let's go press the button, Brian. Yes. All right, that was a doozy question. Let's go to the next one. No, that's important, but. So if yes, which of the following issue areas is most important to you? You can only choose one because this is polling, and unfortunately, you can't choose two. Civil liberties, economy, health, education, health, immigration, and LGBT. Some additional people voted, so let's close this poll. Education. I had thought that I would put an additional option on this that said other. Are there other things that you would say are important to consider as legislative agenda? This is just my free-flowing question, not necessarily what the organizers have asked. Are there other things that you think would be interesting and important for Latinos to consider for legislative agenda? Anyone want to share? Transportation. Anybody else? Jobs. Okay. We do have economy, but jobs specifically. Was that also jobs for this table? Okay.
Right.
Retirement plans. Good one. I have a mole in here. Go ahead, Karen. Environmental concerns. Okay. Yes. Great.
Affordable housing.
Affordable housing. So glad you said that. Yes, so true.
Technology and energy.
Technology and?
Energy.
Great. What about you?
Well, for me, the biggest frustration wealth. I think it's critical to say, I would love to be wealthy so I can donate money to a Latino running for office, so can I afford to go to on a commission because I don't have to worry about X, Y, Z. We never put wealth up there.
That's good wealth commission. Did I see any others? Okay. Environment, okay. All right. Okay, I'm going to go. There's one more.
I want to make a comment. For me, it's hard to see these issues as, let's say this better. To me, these are intersectional issues. So immigration issues are health issues, are education issues. And LGBTQ issues are in every single one of these categories, and we should be applying an LGBTQ inclusive lens to every single category here.
Okay, I'm going to suggest we move to the, okay, there is one. Thank you. Okay, that was good. Thank you so much, and thank you for letting me ask that question. This is my own bonus question that I asked, and let's go to the question. So please select the most appropriate statement for you currently. So I currently provide care for an aging family member or loved one with a disability. I have been a caregiver to a loved one in the past. Expect to be a caregiver in the future. Okay, I'm going to suggest we close this poll. I expect to be a caregiver in the future. Exactly, that's true. I decided I'd ask this because obviously I work for AARP, and you know, a lot of times in all people of color communities, we really think of a lot of times about young people, about jobs, but we also should really be starting to think about aging issues, and caregiving is that pivotal thing. You're either going to need care or you're going to be caring for somebody. And this is one of the issues Eric is working on, so I thought I'd pull and see what people are thinking. Thank you so much for participating. If this is the last question, so just go ahead and put your polling unit in the middle of the bowl, and then we'll be done. Thank you.
Thank you. Let's give a round of applause for letting us use our services. One of the things I wanted to mention is how this information the very last session is with our representatives, Representative Joe Vallejos and Representative Jessica Vega Peterson, and they want to know this information. So we're going to pull that, the polling information, and hand it off to them so they can give you updates of this next legislative session that's coming up. So right now we're going to break for lunch, and what we're going to do is just it's buffet style, so we're going to form lines. And you're free to hold off till when, you know, the line kind of moves a little bit along. So if we can, just kind of these front tables over, and then everyone else follows when they see the line tapering off. So thank you so much, and please feel free to network with our past panelists and enjoy lunch. Buen provecho.